Hey guys, what's up? Andrew here from Sad Games, and we're looking at some London Dare 24 games. What you're looking at here is called Advancer. It's basically just a game where you start off as a cube and you advance and progressively get bigger and bigger into this new outstanding world. There's not really much I can say about the game. It was really fun to play. I enjoyed the creativity behind it. As you can see, it's just as you progress, the world around you changes, but the level stays the same, which means that while the graphics keep updating, it's basically just the same world, but from a different perspective as time goes on. And it's just, I guess in a way it's a really good commentary of how far games have come, where it's like, look, this is what the world used to be like, and now this is what you've slowly evolved the world to become. And while I don't have any quarrels about it, I do have to say that this part, which you're looking at here, where it's the, I guess, SNES stage, was really hard. The fighting was just really obnoxious, and after a while, it does become a little bit tedious to play, going back and forth, and jumping around, getting coins that have no purpose whatsoever, trying to figure out what my goal is, where to go. There's no sense of orientation or direction, but this can all be said for, you know, how things have changed with the progression of video games. Since back in the day, this wasn't a thing. Like, maps and a HUD wasn't, you know, a common feature for all games. And neither were, you know, linear direction. It was a lot of it was just kind of like, do your own thing, and if you live to tell the story, then you live. And I mean, again, it's a platformer made in 48 hours. I'd have to say that for all the textures, the audio, the controls, everything was fluid. And there wasn't really much of an issue, no glitches, no problems, and I mean, straightforward story, had to, you know, just basically get a key, jump down, go all the way to the very, go into the castle, go all the way to the very bottom of the castle, fight the boss, and win. So it's nothing too spectacular on story, nothing that stands out really, except for it follows the theme of evolution really well. And as you can tell by that, with how it just changed between old school graphics to less old graphics. But yeah, so then basically just fight the boss and that's about it. And yeah, so that's Advancer on the Lunum Dare. Check description at the bottom for the link. Next game we're looking at is Angry Fish. I don't remember if you guys know the game Feeding Frenzy. It's really old. I think it was made by PopCap, if I remember correctly. This is kind of the same concept. The idea is that you start out as a really small fish and you keep eating other fishes that are smaller or equal to, or a little bit less equal to your size. And I guess the score at the very top for 10250 or 10250, I'm assuming that's like the limit, that's how far you can get before you win the game. I don't know, I didn't beat the game actually, I just kind of just kept moving until I eventually died. I read the comments, a lot of people just ended up staying small and getting all the way to the very end. There really wasn't a point to eat the fish except for, you know, giving a sense of why the game it was in the London Dare for evolution. As you can see, if you hit the other fish, they start getting berserk and angry at you and start attacking you. You have a certain amount of life. You eventually got to push your way through all these other fish while trying to also eat more fish to get big enough so that these other fish can't punk you around, and if you die, you die. So, BitCraft Evolution. This was actually a really fun game, personally. This is so far out of all the London Dare games I've played, which I think is about 7 right now. This is probably one of my favorite games. Why? I don't know. I have a soft spot for space shooters, I guess. It was one of the first games I ever played in arcade was Asteroids, and I've always just had a really fond fascination of putting my brain to the test of trying to dodge and destroy so many enemies and see how fast I can keep myself up. Now, BitCraft Evolution takes us to another step further, and actually, as you progressively kill more enemies, the world gets more harder around you, obviously, but you also evolve as a ship, and your special moves start out differently, your health keeps going up. The very top of the HUD is your health and your evolution bar, and so the more you keep killing, the more you evolve, and the more you evolve, the faster you can take out more enemies, and, you know, the list goes on. So, it was really unique, really creative. It looks a lot more difficult than it really was. It really wasn't that hard to play through the game. As you can see, I'm not even losing life at this point. I'm just beasting through everything. But it was definitely fun. It was definitely something that I would go through and keep playing again. They have a hardcore mode where you just play relentlessly until you die. I would totally check that out and maybe try that. See how far I can get. But Yeah, so that's about it. Thanks for watching, and if you have any questions or comments, please leave them in the comment section below, and we will do some more of these next time.